Hi, in this video, I'm going to demonstrate how to fail over a production MySQL cluster running on GKE and Portworx. So we have an environment that's already running a single MySQL instance as a Kubernetes deployment. And because we set up the replication factor as 3, it's automatically configured to be redundant and highly available. So we're going to take advantage of this concept and perform a simulated failover on our production MySQL cluster. So let's first take a look at what's available. So we have a MySQL pod that's running as a part of the deployment. It is essentially a replica set. And if you have been following the previous videos, we configured this as a one replica set of a deployment. And this is backed by a PVC that is pointing to a Portworx storage cluster. Now our goal is to simulate a failure and then perform a graceful failover with minimal or no downtime. So let's get started. So we start this by grabbing the name of the pod that we have just seen. So I'm going to store that in this environment variable. So when we look at this pod, it points us to the MySQL pod name. Then we are going to invoke the MySQL shell. So this is going to drop us right inside the MySQL environment within the pod. All right, so now we are within the MySQL environment and we are going to create a sample database called classic models. And this is going to create a sample table with a set of columns. Oops, I need to first make sure that we are using this database. And then we can create the tables. All right. So now we have a table called offices. And let's go ahead and populate a bunch of rows. So this is going to essentially create some sample data with about 7 rows. Let's query this. So when we actually run this, it points us to sample data that we just populated, and we have about 7 rows. Let's also make sure we are able to perform additional queries, for example, retrieving all the offices within the country USA. So this is a MySQL database with pre-populated data. Now what we're going to do is to simulate a node failure, which is a common scenario in production environments. So currently we have 3 nodes. What we are going to do is to get the name of the node that is currently running our MySQL pod and then cordon it off. So cordoning is a process in Kubernetes where further scheduling gets disabled, which means the pod that is currently running on it remains as is, but further pods that are going to be created will not be scheduled on that node. So this will give us a chance to make sure that we are actually talking to another node and we are creating a pod all over again on a different node. And our goal is to retrieve the data and to ensure it is intact. So let's get the node name where our MySQL pod is running. All right, so when we look at this, this is the node on which the pod is running. So let's now go ahead and cordon it off. So cordoning, as I mentioned, will disable scheduling. So kubectl nodes will show us that the third node is now cordoned off where no additional pods can be scheduled. All right. Now we're going to go a step further and do something very crazy. That is deleting the pod that's already scheduled on this node. So let's get the pod name and then let's go ahead and delete this pod. Okay, let's make sure that the pod is completely terminated. So now I'm going to put this in watch mode to show you something interesting. Because this is a part of deployment and we define the replica set as 1, as soon as the pod gets deleted, Kubernetes will immediately schedule another pod. And that's the reason why we notice that one gets terminated and the other one is almost immediately getting created. But because we have disabled scheduling on one of the nodes, this is going to be targeted at maybe the other node where we have no context of MySQL running. But do we get the data back? Is it going to be intact? Well, let's check. Before I go any further, I want to make sure we uncordon the node. So we are bringing back our cluster to the normal mode. We can safely do that because the pod is already scheduled. We don't need to worry about it. Now, let's grab the new pod name that has been recreated by the controller. So now the pod is available in this environment variable. Now, let's go ahead and query the database. So I'm going to invoke the MySQL shell. All right. So do we get the data back? So I'm going to use this data called classic models. Wow, it looks like it's available. And now let's query all the rows from this. And there we go. So even after failing a node and deleting a production database pod, we could successfully create another pod pointing to exactly the same data. And this is done by Portworx. And remember, we set up the replication factor of the storage class as 3, which means the data is simultaneously written across multiple nodes, number one. And number two, thanks to the storage orchestrator for Kubernetes engine of Portworx, it is called Stork. And that is going to ensure that the pod is going to be created on one of the nodes where the data is already replicated. And this hyperconvergence of compute and data will ensure that we always have the pod co-located where the data is, where the storage is. And this is going to give us the optimal performance with minimal downtime. And this is how you can actually perform a failover in production clusters running on Kubernetes and Portworx. I hope you found this useful. Thanks for watching.